Hey, what's going on, everybody? I hope everybody's doing well. Welcome to the channel. Back to the channel. If you're new here, welcome to the channel. I'm Bearded Fortech. A lot of you guys ask me what software I'm using. This right here for the newer vehicles is FDRS, which is that right there. For the older vehicles, it's IDS, and I also have Forscan, but I'm using FDRS because this is a 23 Explorer that I'm messing with right now. And this is a IDS computer. You know, Ford software, VCM3. Paid a lot of money for these. It's wireless. But you guys are asking me how to get this software. This software you have to buy from Ford. And it's $750 a year. And that'll give you access. It'll give you a license key for FDRS and for IDS. To allow you to use both of them. Now, if you wanted to use Forscan, I can exit out of here. Let me turn this on. Now I can go to Forscan. Forscan is $20 for an entire year. So I am wireless. Connect. And Forscan allows you to do some stuff too. You guys have seen me do a couple of Forscan videos, no big deal. But a lot of you guys were asking me, like, when I'm programming modules and software updates and stuff like that, which ones I'm using. And I'm using FDRS or IDS for that. It really depends on what I'm doing. So as soon as this finishes doing what it's doing, I'll exit out of it and I'll go back to FDRS. And then I'll look for a software update so I can show you what I'm talking about. Because Forscan will allow you to change things, and you can program some modules, not all. So it really depends on which module I'm programming. Like if I do a programmable module installation on a body control module or a PCM or something like that, then I use the factory software. Let me disconnect here. So I'm disconnected. I mean, exit out. And yeah, this is touch screen too. I'm a little, I got one of these for PTT, A-Rod. And I didn't even know that had this little stylus on the side. But I'm going to go back into this FDRS right quick. And I'm going to look, see if there's any module updates. So see VCM3 wireless. Okay. Yes. Connect, and you can see I was in here doing some other stuff a minute ago, but it does its network test. And though, even though this thing was built in 12 of 23, you would think it's a 24 model, but it's actually a 23 model. It's kind of weird. So we'll let it do its thing, and then I'm going to check for software updates for some of the modules. Turn the lights off so I don't kill the battery. But you can see down here where I'm connected VCM, I'm connected to the internet. The battery voltage is at 11.8 volts. So see, it's a 23 Explorer, 8,890 miles. So I'm gonna go to toolbox. What are we doing here? Did you just freeze? I'm an idiot. It helps if I hit the button. So I want to go software updates. So PCM and body control both have an update. So while I'm here doing what I need to do to this truck, then I will go ahead and do the software update. So these codes here, that was from earlier when I was messing with the park brake system. I'm gonna clear that. Yeah, we're all good. Go back over to toolbox. So it does have a software update for the PCM and for the BCM, so I'll do that later. But the whole reason this people were asking me what software I use, so obviously, I need to update the PCM and the BCM, so I have to use FDRS to do this. So that is the software that I use. That's where you get it from. If you want workshop manual, you can log in dealer connection. Internet's slow today. And see, I'm logged in right now, but you can go to FordMotorCraftService.com and you can get access to a workshop manual. You can purchase it, or I think they have free versions and stuff like that. But, you know, vehicle ID, you know, previous VINs, working with a 23 Explorer. And that's the vehicle I'm in now. It's got the 2.3 liter in it. No recalls. So that's the programs that I use. It's going to be FDRS for the newer ones, IDS for the older ones, and then Forscan depending on what I'm doing. So I hope that helps you guys out. I appreciate you asking me the questions. So I will recommend getting Forscan if you're just trying to do some stuff on your truck. And if you don't know what you're doing, please reach out to, you know, me or Powerstroke Tech Talk with A-Rod. He's a really good whiz on this Forscan, and so is Cody with CP's Garage. We can all help you out with your Forscan stuff, turn things on and off. But I love you guys, and I'll see you on the next one.